of 613 mitzvahs we have, it's actually two mitzvahs, one to put the tefillin on the arm and one on the head. So a person that, God forbid, doesn't have a hand, God forbid, he puts on the tefillin shalosh, is yotzei that mitzvah.
What happens if he has a hand but no head?
Yeah, actually a friend of mine, Rabbi Halperin from Israel, came with his son to the Rebbe on Yechidus, and the Rebbe asked him that question. But the boy was so excited, emotional. The Rebbe is asking him, so he didn't think, what do you do if you don't have a head? And the Rebbe smiles if you don't have a head. So, Shaliyad is the hand. It's written on one long piece. And inside we have the four pashas, four portions of the Torah that mention the mitzvah of tefillin. Let's concentrate here on number three, which is the smallest and most famous one. Now right here at the end of line number five, we have Ukshatam, the Ois, Al Yadecha, Ve'ayuletetofes ben Einecha. We say daily, every morning and night. And that is the mitzvah of tefillin. Hashem is telling us you have to put on tefillin every day, on your hand and on your head. The same is mentioned, Kadesh Lian V'Hayakiv Yachal, which are mentioned in Chumash Mois, the second book of the Torah. Shemayin V'Hayim Shemayin are mentioned in Chumash Dvarim, the last one. The second parasha that is over here, you see Yodcha, is written Yud Dalet Chav Hei. Proper Hebrew, you can ask your Abba, this is how it's supposed to be written, Yodcha, Yud Dalet Chav. Right. Why is it written in such a funny way? Chazal learned from it something very special, that we are putting our tefillin on our weaker hand, yad, keha. We break this into two words. So it's the weak hand, which is for a righty, a left hand, and for a left-handed person, the right hand. You are right-handed. So you're going to put on tefillin on your left. I'm going to put it right here on the muscle in a way that when you put your arm down, it's going to be right across from your heart. Very good. So these four parashas in this order will be Shaliyad of the Rashi. Same four parashas, a different order, will be Rabbeinu Tam. The last two only are changing. Shema is going to be as number four, and Vehayam Shemaya is going to be as number three. And also Vehayam Shemaya and the Rashi ends at the end of the line, and the Rabbeinu Tam, you're going to see soon, ends a bit before that. So it's an open parasha. This is the yad, it's going to be rolled and inserted into one big hole. Only one hole in the shell yad, it's all inserted in. The same four parashas written on four separate pieces, and on four lines instead of seven, are going to be inserted in the shalosh. The shalosh, the head, has four holes. So it's going to be each one individually into one of the holes. The cloth we use, the parchment we use for the shalosh, is a bit thinner. You can feel the difference.
Why is one thinner and one thicker?
The hole for the shaliyad is big. You can just roll in it. The hole for the shalosh is very narrow, so we have to fold the pashas. Fetch this. The thicker. So when we're going to put this pasha in, this is Kadeshli, it's one of the longest. He's going to take some measurements, etc., but we want to fold it in a way that will not damage the ink and the pressure over here, and this area is still going to be rounded a bit, not to squeeze them too much as we can. The width of the hole you're going to see is about 5 millimeters. It's very small, very small. Okay, so this is Alter Rebbe's ksav. It's a very special ksav invented by the Alter Rebbe. This Kislev was a few days ago. It's a ksav that combined all the other opinions. It combines ksav Arizal, Sfadi, Ashkenazi, everything. Peace on earth. It's all in here. It's very hard to write. The sefer that wrote it is a very big mumche. He knows the ksav very well, very experienced. Over 60 years old, big rabbi in Israel. And your parents chose the very best. Any questions so far, Itamar? Should we discuss the batim?
Uh-huh.
The boxes, the black boxes. All right, let me bring a few samples. Mm-hmm.